Howdy, and welcome to another episode of the almost world famous Cactus Atlas. On today's episode, I'm coming at you from northern Arizona, specifically the north rim of the Grand Canyon, and I'm camping here at the North Campground. It's my very first visit here ever. Really super excited. And I want to give you a tour of this campground and let you know what I think. So if you want to find out all that, stick around and let's go check it out. Man, I am super stoked. I think I lucked out with this campground. This exceeds all of my expectations. Usually they do, because most of the sites here are fantastic, but this particular site gives me an awesome vibe this time. Well, we'll start with a quick tour of the campground today, and the very first thing that I always like to show off is where I decided to put my tent. And I decided there was a little alcove here amongst these ponderosa pines on my campsite, and that seemed like a nice little place to put the tent. There's something mythic about camping next to these ponderosa pine. I love these trees. The other thing about ponderosa pines that I love are how they smell. And sometimes I would pick the scent up and I didn't really realize it. But recently I went on a trip on the Grand Canyon Railway, and one of the attendants said, they were telling you facts about the area, and she mentioned that ponderosa pines smell like a combination of vanilla and butterscotch. And I was like, Now you don't smell it kind of just walking around as strongly, but if you go up to one and you smell it, like really close, like that, it absolutely 100% smells exactly like vanilla and butterscotch. It is such a good smell. I wish I could bottle that up and bring it home with me. And as standard with any campsite here, you get a fire ring. And as always at the national parks, you will typically get a nice picnic table. This one's very similar to the one that we had at the Mather Campground at the south rim of the Grand Canyon. It's just a big chunk of hard concrete. That's not gonna blow anywhere. So the way this campground is configured, there's a one-way loop that kind of winds around the whole campground, intersected by other one-way streets that go this way. Each campground has a little driveway. It's a loop, as you could see here. And the rangers did ask that you kind of park in the correct direction in case you have to evacuate in an emergency. I'm assuming probably because of forest fires or something like that, which these forests are very prone to forest fires this time of the year. One thing that I love right off the bat, well, two things that I love right off the bat here at this campground is that it's amongst these huge ponderosa pines and very well shaded. So that's always a big plus, although it is a little bit chilly up here. It's probably in the low 60s right now. Also, the campgrounds are spread out very nicely. You're not as close to your neighbors as you'll get at other national park campgrounds. So I'm pretty impressed with how spaced out they actually have this campground. And you can see my campground right there. There's my tent, and this is the drinking water right next to my tent. Now, another thing, you can see my tent, and if I face this direction, that little cabin looking structure are the restrooms and the dumpster. So let's go take a walk down there and take a look at the facilities. So here you can see you've got your dumpster for your main trash, but they also have trash cans for aluminum containers as well as plastic containers. So they do recycle here. Have not seen that at all of the national parks unless I've overlooked it. And here by the bathroom here is the sink where you will wash your dishes, and another view of the restroom. Let's go take a peek and see how they look. All right, here's the facility. Very clean, nice looking toilets, and a couple sinks. So no showers in this restroom, although there are showers and a laundromat here, which we're gonna go take a peek at here in a little bit. All right, let's go walk around a little bit more and check this campground out. Now, I haven't focused on these in my previous campground reviews, and I'm gonna try to start doing a better job with it, but I think most of the national parks do have accessible campsites, and this one, the folks haven't arrived yet, but you can see you've got your driveway here. And then if you walk this way, notice that it's nice and paved. So if you have a wheelchair or some kind of accessibility need, this is a really nice campground. You even have your own private paved path here to get to the restroom. So here's another campsite that kind of borders the main loop like mine does. Site 61. Yeah, see, you get so much like space. That trailer back there is the neighboring campsite on the other side. And then you got the one right here, but nothing here. I suppose people could probably fight over the space in between to put up their tents. But other than that, they are nicely spaced. Now, some other general information for you if you visit, at least as of the time of recording this, check-in to the campground is at noon and check-out is 11 a.m. Here's an interesting site. This is a site that doesn't seem to have ponderosa pines in it. I think those might be aspens, I'm not sure. Another thing too that I'll let you know, as I found out, this campground is pretty much booked for a long time to come. It does have a short season though. Eventually, I think it's December 1st, they close down all the roads coming into the North Rim, so this place shuts down. And I wanna say it's in October when they shut the campground down. Now maybe for a future note, I'm kinda digging this site here, site 36. These border the woods. I'm kind of in the middle. Even though it feels like I'm in the woods, this truly, there's nothing back there. So the only thing I don't like about site 36 maybe is it is sloped. So if you set your tent up, which I'm assuming you're gonna do down there, it is slightly sloped and that may be kind of uncomfortable in the evening because sleeping on a hill is not the most comfortable thing as I've found out. Another set of bathrooms over here. Like I told you, these bathrooms are all over the place, so you're not gonna have any problems finding one. And over here, this building is where you register when you arrive here at the canyon. Now, one really awesome thing about this campground is within walking distance from my tent is a laundromat and showers, coin-operated showers. So while you're waiting for your laundry, they even have tables out here that you could sit at, relax, have a soda from one of the machines. Now, one thing I'm gonna caution you on is if you ever come camp at one of these national parks, at least the ones that I've been to, internet service is not very reliable. And this park is no exception. I don't get the greatest signal, but I have been getting enough of a signal in my campsite to be able to at least send text messages back and forth with my wife. And they do take a while to send, but they've been going through reliably. But don't count on it. Okay, so we've done some touring, checked out some campsites. I think now I need to go buy some firewood for the evening. So I'm gonna head out to the general store and see what I can find. And here's the general store and gifts. Take a peek inside. Looks like they have a little coffee shop up here and snacks. Little breakfast items, donuts, cookies, coffee. That's what I'm talking about here. Lots of frozen meats, ground beef, chicken, sausages, pork chops. Looks like they're all frozen, so you would need to thaw them out. Lots of chips. You got some produce, oranges, fruit here. Ooh, you've got AM jerky. I've never seen that before. It's like a breakfast bacon jerky. That sounds good. You got all sorts of snacks. A lot of extra camping equipment if you forgot something. First aid kits, lights, everything you need to survive here. And even some Grand Canyon merch. Oh, that hat's kind of loud, but I kind of like it. $20. So if you've seen my video on the South Rim, general store. That's a much larger, pretty much like a full service grocery store. This general store, much smaller, but pretty much anything you need is in there. It's really nice, really clean, really convenient, because the campground is right here. So now I always like to complain about the price of firewood and ice. Today I decided to buy ice before I left home and packed my cooler with it at my local grocery store. We have Safeway here in Arizona. I spent $2.50 for ice there. Here was about a buck more, so not too bad. It's actually pretty reasonable. And then the firewood, $7.48. I think that's about on par with what I've been paying at campgrounds. Maybe a little bit more. I don't remember already what I paid, but it was in the $6-$7 range. So once again, minor gripe, I suppose. You pay for convenience. And to be honest with you, I don't know what firewood normally costs anyway, so maybe that's the normal price. So earlier, when I was complaining about the price of firewood, I didn't look carefully, but you could see I bought two bundles of wood. They are much more generous about the firewood up here than they are at the other parks. So I thought we could explore some of the surrounding area next to the campground, since we've gotten a good look at the campground itself. So let's go see what we can find. Now, one thing you want to note when you come to the North Rim, or if you're thinking about it is isolated. It is not near much. This little campground is almost like its own self-sustaining community. You could see once again right down there is the general store. And if I turn around here next to the campground entrance, you have a little Sinclair gas station here inside the national park. And I'm assuming the reason being is, like, you are so far from anything else that, like, you could get stranded out here if you didn't have that. So that's pretty cool. I don't know if I've ever seen a gas station inside of a national park before. I'm sure there is. I've been to a few, and I'm trying to lengthen that list here on the Cactus Atlas, but this is a first for me. Now, I was thinking it was gonna be through the roof, and yeah, it is more expensive here, but not by too terribly much, I suppose. I filled up my tank this morning in Phoenix at my local gas station, and I spent $2.97 per gallon. So this is about 20 cents more a gallon compared to what I was paying for gas in Phoenix this morning. So more expensive, but I suppose they could gouge you a lot worse if they wanted to, because you really don't have any other choice here. The law of supply and demand. So to give you an idea of just how far out there the North Rim is, at the Grand Canyon National Park that is, the two nearest towns to here that would have like a full medical facility or like a full-size grocery store, for example, would either be Kanab, Utah, which is about 80 miles away, and on the windy roads you take in here, you're not riding on a highway. It's about an hour and a half away, according to Google. The other would be Page, Arizona, where that would be where Glen Canyon Dam is located, and that's about 123 miles away, according to Google, 2.5 hour drive from here. So yeah, the North Rim is not the most accessible place by car. It takes a long time to get here, wherever you're coming from, especially if you're south of the canyon like I am. And here we are at the North Rim Visitor Center. Here's some information about the overall layout. You could see I'm staying here at the North Rim Campground. Right now, I've taken the car down to here. I'm at the Visitor Center. And, you know, if you want to see some really good views, it sounds like your best bet, and I'm going to be exploring this later, is to take a 45-minute drive all the way down here on this plateau down to Cape Royal. So I'm hearing that is supposed to be one of your best places to go. But one thing I wanted to also note is when I've been filming, I'm looking off this direction here. The Grand Canyon is actually down here. So we're kind of, this whole thing is situated next to like a, it's Bright Angel Canyon, but it's like another canyon that is an offshoot of the main canyon. So let's go take a look inside here. Looks like you have another gift shop here with more stuff than the general store. A lot of neat t-shirts up here. I like that one. Lots of hats and books and maps. Other various sundries here. Bandanas. So that visitor center was pretty small, but kind of quaint. Now that I'm exploring a lot more here at the North Rim, this main area, it feels more wildery, if that's a good choice of words, than the South Rim. Just more, like, it's just cooler, like with cabins, and not that they don't have this stuff up at the South Rim, or down at the South Rim, but I don't know, I'd prefer the vibe of this at the North Rim over the South Rim, for sure, even though everything in terms of scale is much smaller. Another view of some of these cabins. I see what look like regular old folks chilling out on their porch, so I'm gonna bet these are rentable. And look at this, imagine if you were staying in one of these and you've got this Bright Angel Canyon right over here. This is indeed the view of the Grand Canyon. That would be the South Rim, way out over there. And the coolest thing of all is, I don't know if you could see that mountain way off in the distance, the biggest one of them all. That is Flagstaff. That is the San Francisco Peaks. We can actually see that from here, and it's so far away. It's so strange because I've been on the other side of the canyon looking this direction, and you can actually kind of see down onto that. Whereas from the other side, you're looking up because this is about 1,000 feet higher than the other side. Now you can see the trail here to get to the Bright Angel Point overlook is nicely paved. So once again, seems pretty accessible, although there is kind of a steep grade at times, so you want to be careful. Not sure where I'm going here. I'm going to just keep following this for a little bit. How vertiginous is that? That just drops down. Oh my goodness. Now, one thing too that I'm noticing, so I'm getting a lot more winded by this relatively simple walk, I think because of the elevation here. I believe we're over 8,000 feet here in elevation, so maybe the air's a little thinner or something. I don't know, I didn't really read up on that to know if that's a thing or not here. If 8,000 feet is high enough to make you a little more winded than usual. I think this might be the end. Let's see. And this trail winds around here. Yep, and here's the end of the trail, the overlook. That's a long way down. I also like these rocky overlooks. I see folks kind of hanging out up there. There are not signs saying not to go there. It could be pretty treacherous because that's a straight drop down. But I did take advantage of one of those overlooks at the end and got a really nice view. Okay, so I just wanted to kind of venture out here out to Bright Angel Point to get a quick view of the canyon and to show you that there are some spectacular views in close proximity to the campground. Definitely within walking distance, but driving saves some time. And you can see up there, that also gives you a reference point to show you how far we walked to get out to the end of Bright Angel Point. That looks like that's Yavapai Lodge. If I'm not mistaken, my next destination, we're gonna go check that out. I need to make a quick correction. I've referred to this as the Yavapai Lodge on a couple occasions. I'm not sure why I said that, because it's not called that. It's called the Grand Canyon Lodge, as you can see right there. Let's go take a peek inside and see what we see. That is quite the fireplace. I could literally walk inside of that. That is a beautiful lodge. That was fantastic. It looks like they have a nice restaurant in there. I think there's a saloon over here we can go check out really quick. It looks pretty hopping in there, pretty crowded, and I didn't want to disturb people, so. But anyway, yeah, there's a full bar in there. So that's kind of a nice thing to have out here in the middle of nowhere. And it looks like there's a gift shop here. And it looks like here at the lodge, they also have a deli. A deli in the pines. Looks like they've got a lot of quick service stuff, salads and pre-made sandwiches. So a lot of pre-made things, but they will make some things to order, it looks like. Oh, it smelled so good in there. I'm really hungry. I'm not gonna spoil myself. I brought my own food, camping stuff. But yeah, if you don't want to go through the hassle of making your own food or whatnot, yeah, that deli seemed to be just the place. Okay, and I did confirm at the visitor center that all of those cabins we saw, they are rentable. Now I didn't get information about pricing and how far in advance you need to book, but I tell you what I'm gonna do for you, because I'm interested to know. We'll do some research before we post this video, and we'll put information down in the description below with all that, because I think Amy and I need to come up here and do this as soon as we can. Might not be until next year at this point, but yeah, that's too good to pass up, I'd say. All right, I am back from viewing a beautiful sunset. Arrived here at camp, and of course, I got the fire going really nicely. So one thing also that I can note is this is a very, very dark campground. I think you're in the pines, and I could see stars through the treetops. Oh, wow. The sun hasn't been down for that long, and it is beautiful. Very little light pollution over here. I mean, there is some. I'm not too far from the general store over there, but other than the occasional car driving by, I'm sure you could see the Milky Way out here. Well, good morning. It is my last morning here. I'm packing up my camp. Just woke up and I came across some grazing mule deer right across from my campsite. Looks like a mother and maybe two small ones. It's a nice little gift, departing gift, guys. All right, so I wanted to give you a few final thoughts about my stay here at the North Campground at the Grand Canyon. Overall, it was an excellent stay. I was here a total of 2 nights. And the notable things that stick out in my mind are, it was absolutely beautiful to camp amongst all the ponderosa pines. You get a lot of nice shade. The sites were very clean. The campground was very quiet. And the sites were spread out a little bit further than your average national park. At least it felt that way to me, giving you a nice little element of a little extra privacy. The facilities were awesome. You had the general store, laundromat, shower. I did end up taking a shower, and it cost 6 quarters for 6 minutes. So a quarter a minute, just so you know. But other than that, yeah, this was an awesome place, and I really look forward to the next time I come back here. So I definitely recommend it. Try to make it up here if you can. If you're new here, please subscribe to our channel, and if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Also, hit that notification bell to stay informed of whenever we release new videos, which we're doing all of the time. Finally, you could find us on social media at Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram under the name Cactus Atlas. Well, I gotta get on out of here. I hope you enjoyed this episode, and we'll see you on a new one right around the corner. Take it easy, and see you later.